There are jungle forts like Vishalgarh or Jungli Jaigarh and Tipagarh and Khairagarh. In Gadha and Mandla, in Gondwan alone, there are 52 forts. And you may not have heard the name of all those forts, but I had visited at least 15, 16 forts in Gadha Mandla, where even today the water is abundantly available. Rashtrakoot, Bahamani, and of course forts. Let us see. Here you can see one is the fort over there, it's called a Jivdan. There are four forts, Jivdan, Shivneri, then Parvatgad, and Sawad, or Zund, or Prasannagad, and then of course Harishchandragad range. The steps and the stairs, including the railings, are carved out in the stone. There are plenty of water available on the top of the fort. And now the people who are staying at the bottom, now they have put the pipes and they are bringing water from the top of the fort to the villages. Here you can see a water cistern over here, but it looks very small. The water is quite clean over there right now, but it is very deep inside. It's almost 60 to 70 feet deep. Now this prevents the evaporation, that canopy. It prevents the evaporation of the water. So you will find that the caves, old caves, each cave will have one water system. And it is deep inside. So the evaporation factor is ruled out over there. So this is Satavahan at Nane Ghat and Jivdan. But they built so many caves at the Kanheri caves are there, of course they are Buddhist caves. But then Junnar area, there are 365 caves. Bhimashankar is one. In Manmodi Hill, Bhimashankar, Amba, Ambika, even Shivneri fort has a lot of caves. And each cave has a separate system, water system over there. On the top, you will find Ganga and Jamna. Two water systems, but they are like this kunda only, deep inside, almost 60 to 70 feet deep. So this particular aspect must be studied. My last side, of course, I am going to talk about the Katras. With the Katras lakes and the entire system was built in Peshwa era. And my ancestors, they built some aqueducts in Pune, right from Babdev Ghat to Rastapet. I belong to that family, Raste. And we have Persian wheels at, and which is working right now in Wai, in Motibagh. And there are fountains and water is abundant over there. But I have studied this particular aqueduct of Raste from Babdev Ghat. It is a clay pipe. People can walk through it. And we had a treaty with Shindes, Mahaji Shinde, when he came to Pune, we had a treaty. And one duct was taken to Anavdi. But otherwise, our gardens in Rastapet, in Rastewada, the fountains, and even the wells, they get water from Babdev Ghat through that aqueduct. The length of that duct is almost 6 to 7 kilometers. Pune has got 4 or 5 sources. One is from Katras, second is from Ambega Unare, third is the Raste's aqueduct from Babdev. Fourth is Rupram Kataras, and the fifth in Shukravar Pet. It's a very small duct. So from 5 different places, the water aqueducts were constructed underground, and even water is still there even today. Now Kataras, I will discuss a little later, but Jivdan and this particular, they are known, they are quite ancient forts. Belgaum Fort, you will find there is a lake there, and the fort over here, there is a moat, and the lake outside the fort, outside the moat. So in case of any enemy attacks, the enemy will have a water source through the lake. But when I moved and when I saw this particular system, I started checking up, and I came to know that there are some walls. They are fitted over here at the bottom of that lake, and at the time of enemy attack, the water from the lake was taken into the moat around the fort, and the lakes were empty. So the enemy will not have water. It's a twofold, it was twofold. The moat, it prevents enemy from coming inside the fort. And secondly, the water is available to the wells or the ard or the bowries inside the fort. So Belgaum fort, the construction of that Belgaum fort started in the Rashtrakut era. And of course, there were several rulers, including Marathas. So it has to be studied, but it's a very large moat. And the lake, it's a unique system at Belgaum. It's a Rashtrakut Yadav Devgiri. As I said, the Rashtrakut started carving out. You know how much stone has been removed from that fort? It's in millions of tonnage. If we take the basalt, the specific gravity of basalt 2.7, and almost one square yard, it weighs about 2.5 tonnes. It will be in few millions of tonnes. The stone has been taken out from that particular hillock, and three ramparts, three curtain walls were constructed using that particular stone. Then there is Andhari inside. Mahakot, there are three layers, and each has a moat. Each particular curtain wall that has a moat. So Devgiri, the water system has to be studied quite carefully. On the top, you will find there are water systems, and at the bottom of that fort, there are huge lakes. There are huge lakes. So many rulers were there. First were Rashtrakut, then were Shilars. Of course, I had not put the names of Shilar over here. But the Yadav, at the time of Yadav, and Aladdin Khalji, when he attacked, then Yadav had to surrender. And then Khalji rule started. After Khalji came Tughlaqs after Bahmani. Bahmani, then Nizam Shahi. Nizam Shahi and Bahmani, we had a lot of constructions for the water. Nizam Shahi rulers, Mughal rulers, as well as Maratha rulers. Now here, Rashtrakut Bahmani Kandhar. Kandhar is a fort near Nanded. And it's a land fort, but it has a huge moat. There is another thing, and even today there is water. That particular talao or lake has been constructed by Rashtrakut Jagatunga, and it's called as Jagatunga Samudra. I'll give you a little idea of what it is, Jagatunga Samudra, because it's quite unique, and in the last 1,000 years the system has been working over there. Jagatunga Samudra length of the dam is 830 meters. The height of the dam, that Jagatunga Samudra, is 102 meters. The maximum water level is 100 meters. Width of the dam is 6 meters. Now it is constructed in the Rashtrakut era. And there is still water in that Jagatunga. Of course, I need not give all those details, but you must see, you must go and visit Kandhar at least once. It's a beautiful fort. Let me narrate one example. I was at Nanded for some time, and then I came to know that there was some communal riot took place, or somewhere in Nanded or around Nanded. So we decided to leave Nanded and come to Pune. So while coming back, we saw the board, Kandhar. So we went to Kandhar. And actually that incident, that communal riot had happened over there at Kandhar only. We just walked into the trap. On one side there was one madarsa, another side there is a fort, this Kandhar fort. You know, Kandhar fort, there is a huge deity. Now it's broken completely. There's a ek paul yavda hai, sir. It's almost 6 or 7 feet. The statue would have been at least 77 feet in height. But it is completely broken now. But Kandhar fort It's a very beautiful fort, and Bahmanis, they made the construction of the fort. There is a Sher Haji. The height of those bastions is very low, as if you are aware of the glacis and the covered ways, and then only you will come to know why the height of the bastions is low, because if you fire the cannon shot, it goes over the fort, so it doesn't damage the fort. So Kandhar water source. Now the medieval forts are Vellore. This Vijayanagar rulers, they started construction. Naladurga is another fort. It's a beautiful fort. One must visit in the rainy season. Third is Raigad. It was a fort earlier, but Shivaji, it became the capital of Shivaji. Coronation took place over there. Burhanpur, there is a fort. There is one hill fort adjacent to Burhanpur, is Ashirgad. And Burhanpur is on the bank of Tapi. There is a small fort, and the water system is to be studied over there. Nizam, of course, Panchakki and all those things, but let us see Vellore fort. Here is the moat, and the moat is almost 120 feet, and still there is water. Even today, if you visit, you will find the water at Vellore. Vijayanagar people, they started construction, but Vijayanagar kingdom was destroyed in 1565. By Nizam Shahi, the Bidar, the Barid Shahi, as well as the Adil Shahi rulers. But they captured the fort, and later on, they increased the water capacity inside the fort of Vellore. The Vijayanagar or the Vellore, it's a medieval, beautiful fort. It's on the way from Bangalore to Madras. Naladurga, it is in Usmanabad district, and I'll give you a very small idea. Nemat Khan was one fellow who built Farah Baksh Bagh at Ahmednagar. That fellow, he put a wall over there, blocked the water. Then the water from that river, the name of that river is Bori. So, actually, it flows through the fort. It flows through the fort, and it makes a moat, a natural moat for that particular fort. Then here you can see the wall, and of course, those two, Nar and Madi, overflows. But in this particular dam, this wall, inside there are mahals. And the temperature in the summer, it goes up to 44, 45 degrees. So people used to go and sit over there in the mahal, and the water flows around them. So Naladurga, there are a lot of stories of Naladurga. There is a stone inscription of Nemat Khan, who had built and who had made all those arrangements of water. Actually, it surrounds the fort again, and that Buri goes. There is one Upli Buruz, or a huge bastion, observation tower. From that particular tower, you get the entire, you can see the entire fort, including this moat, as well as this Pani Mahal, Panchakki, and the river name is Bori. It is to be studied. If you go on 15th of August, you will find at least 15,000 people visiting that particular fort. And these two overflows, and people are swimming over there. The third is Raigad. Now the Raigad, Malikambar had come over here at Raigad. The Raigad, earlier it belonged to Vijayanagar. But then when Shivaji captured it, and Shivaji reconstructed the entire fort, Raigad, what I just calculated, there are six huge lakes over there, and the total capacity may be 15,000 crores of liters. And there are 300 houses on that particular fort. Here you can see Ganga Sagar and these towers. People used to come and sit over here. Here, Shivaji drank water from this particular talab, or Ganga Sagar. Bala Kulhatkar, here. What Kavi Bhushan also had come over here, and he was at Raigad, and he constructed poetry on that. But what Bal Kodatkar or Kavi Bhushan has said, I will narrate it in Marathi. Jata Bandhuni Natali Dharani Vishala Palash Vrukshancha Lata Taruna Vilabuni Dulati Nath Chalato Chayecha Kuthe Bandhalya Jalashayavar Jina Shubhato Dagdancha Vihara Chale Tya Panyavar Chakra Vakakari Hausancha Kothe Chandana Kuthe Chameli Gandhataravade Safyacha लवंग वेली कुठे वेलेची लक्षण पुरतो संख्येचा चंद्रमुखींच्या सवेच जेव्हा चंद्र उगवतो पूर्वेचा असे वाटते कमल फुलांनी जन्म घेतला आजच उदरी गंगेच्या वरती गंगा आकाश गंगा मिल्की वे तो आता कंपॅरिझन करतायत कवी वरती गंगा खाली सागर हा गंगा सागर वरती गंगा खाली सागर वरती तारे येथे कमले वरचे तारे खाली येती प्रतिबिंबांना रूपे पडती म्हणून म्हणतो भूषण हे की आकाशाच्या गंगेहूनही गंगा सागर भाग्याचा तरी म्हणतो गंगा सागर का भाग्य इतना थोरे वो मिल्की वे से भी अधिक ज्यादा है देर आर सिक्स ह्यूज एंड नाउ आई विल टेल यू व्हाट देर वर अर्लियर वेरी स्मॉल सिस्टम्स But there is a system, there are veins, there are cracks in the basalt, there are veins and the springs, they bring water.